Welcome to the third session of the beta function. In the last session we have seen the examples of the type to evaluate the integral integration a to b x minus a raised to m into b minus x raised to n dx. Now in this third session we are going to consider the examples based on the basic formula integration 0 to 1 x raised to m minus 1 into 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx is equal to beta of m n. This is the basic formula for the beta function. Now using this we will try to solve some examples. So in that let us consider first example number 1. Evaluate integration 0 to n x raised to n into n minus x raised to p dx. Okay. Now you can see that the integration, it is not in the proper form of that beta function, but certainly we can reduce it to this form by substitution. And for that, always remember one thing. Here in the basic formula of beta function we have 1 minus x, and here in the example we have n minus x. That n minus x we have to convert to 1 minus t type, because a new variable of substitution will be t. So how this n minus x will be converted to 1 minus t? So for that we have to do some substitution, and what the substitution will be, put x is equal to n into t. Because if you observe this thing carefully, here we have n minus x. I will write here n minus x. To look it in the form of 1 minus t, n minus, if I consider x as a n t, so that n I can take common, so n into bracket what I will have, 1 minus t. And in the example there is a bracket raised to p, so this thing will be bracket raised to p. Okay, so always remember this logic for converting that term to the 1 minus t type. So here we have to put x is equal to n into t, and derivative dx is equal to n dt. Also we have to check the change in the limits also. After putting that x is equal to n t, what happens to the limits? So for x is equal to 0, lower limit, when x is 0, what you can say about t? T is also 0. And when x is equal to n, when x is equal to n, n will be equal to n t, means t will be equal to 1. It means limit after substitution, limit changes to 0 to 1. So with this substitution, the integral I will become I is equal to integration 0 to 1 x raised to n, but x is n t, so it will be n t raised to n into n minus x is n t bracket raised to p, and dx is n dt. Okay, so that implies I is equal to integration 0 to 1 n raised to n into t raised to n, from this taking n outside with the power p, so it will be n raised to p into bracket what remains, 1 minus t raised to p into n dt. So that implies I is equal to integration 0 to 1. Note that this n raised to n is constant, n raised to p is also constant, and this n raised to 1. So by law of indices that we can add as integration 0 to 1 n raised to n plus p plus 1, and the remaining terms are t raised to n into 1 minus t raised to p dt. Okay, now take constant outside the integration, so it is I is equal to n raised to n plus p plus 1 into integration 0 to 1 of t raised to n into 1 minus t raised to p dt. Now using the basic formula, beta mn is equal to integration 0 to 1 x raised to m minus 1 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx. Here we have t raised to n, so n we can write as n plus 1 minus 1, and 1 minus t raised to p, so p we can write as p plus 1 minus 1. So writing that I is equal to n raised to n plus p plus 1 integration 0 to 1 t raised to n plus 1 minus 1. We are not changing the power, n is n as it is, but we are writing it in the form of minus 1 into 1 minus t raised to p. How we can write p plus 1 minus 1? Okay, so by using definition of beta function, that integral i is beta of n plus 1 p plus 1. The remaining is as it is. So I will be equal to n raised to n plus p plus 1 into beta of n plus 1 comma p plus 1. Okay, this is the required final answer. This is the required final answer for first example. And substitution is x is equal to nt to get that 1 minus form, 1 minus t time. Okay, let us consider second example. Evaluate integration 0 to 1 into x cube into 1 minus root x raised to 5 dx. Now again the situation is similar. We have the integral and there is no 1 minus t type. There is 1 minus root x. 1 minus root x. So how to convert this to 1 minus t? So what you have to put? Put root x as a t. So what is the substitution here? Put root x is equal to, root x is equal to t, that is x is equal to t square. X is equal to t square, and we are considering the substitution as per the requirement 1 minus t. 1 minus t. So here we have x is equal to t square. Now what will be the derivative? Dx is equal to 2t dt. Derivative of this x is equal to t square is dx is equal to 2t dt. What about the limits? When x is equal to 0, what you can say about t? T is also 0. And when x is 1, t is also 1. So limits remains unchanged. Limits are 0 to 1 as it is. So with this substitution, that given integral will become, called as I is equal to integration 0 to 1 x cube. X is t square, so x cube will be t raised to 6 into 1 minus root x is t raised to 5, and dx is what? 2t dt. So just simplify this, take constants outside. So this will be equal to, this is equal to, what do I have? It is equal to 2, you can take outside, 2 into integration 0 to 1 t raised to 6, and this t means t raised to 7 into 1 minus t raised to 5 dt. So that implies I is equal to 2 into integration 0 to 1. Powers we have to write in the minus 1 form. So that 7 we can write as 8 minus 1 into 1 minus t raised to 5 we can write as 6 minus 1. So we can use the definition of beta function. So that implies I is equal to 2 into beta of, by definition of beta function, this thing is beta of 8, 6. That implies I is equal to 2 into beta of 8, 6 by using the relation between beta and gamma. Beta 8, 6 is gamma 8 into gamma 6 divided by gamma of 8 plus 6. So that implies I is equal to 2 into gamma 8. What is gamma 8? By gamma function property it is 7 factorial. Gamma 6 is 5 factorial, and gamma 8 plus 6, that is gamma 14, and gamma 14 is 13 factorial. So this is the final answer. You can simplify it further. we can simplify it further by putting the values of 7 factorial, 5 factorial, 13 factorial. Okay, so this is the second example we have done. Let us consider another example. Let's consider third example. Third example is evaluate example 3. Evaluate integration 0 to 1 dx divided by under root 1 minus x raised to m. Okay, so let us call the integral as I. So I is equal to, in the example, integration 0 to 1 dx upon under root 1 minus x raised to m. So that implies I is equal to integration 0 to 1 dx divided by root means raised to 1 by 2 means this root 1 minus x raised to m we can consider as 1 minus x raised to m bracket raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so that implies I is equal to integration 0 to 1. Now shifting the denominator to the numerator side, so what it will become? 1 minus x raised to m raised to minus 1 upon 2 dx. If we shift, that power becomes minus sign, negative. Okay, now our requirement is what? 1 minus t. So to get 1 minus t, what we have to put x raised to m as a t, simple. So put x raised to m equal to t, and what about its derivative? If we differentiate it, its derivative will be m into x raised to m minus 1 dx is equal to dt. So that implies dx is equal to 1 upon m into x raised to m minus 1 dt. That implies dx is equal to 1 upon m into x raised to m equal to t. So what you can say about if x raised to m is t, then what is x? X will be equal to t raised to 1 upon m. By taking m root on both sides, this is the value of x. So if x is t raised to 1 upon m, what is x raised to m minus 1? X raised to m minus 1 will be t raised to 1 upon m raised to m minus 1. So that I am putting here 1 upon x raised to m. By using this, it is t raised to 1 upon m, that is x raised to m minus 1 and then dt. So that implies dx is equal to, what is dx? Therefore dx is equal to 1 upon m into, this will be 1 upon t raised to m minus 1 upon m, t raised to, t to the power m minus 1 upon m dt. So this is substitution for dx. This is a substitution for x raised to m. Just we have to check the limits. So when x is 0, what is t? Put 0 here. So 0 raised to m 0 means t is also 0 for x 0. And when x is upper limit 1, so it will be 1 raised to m. So t again it is 1. So limits remains unchanged. So with this substitution, that given integral becomes I is equal to integration 0 to 1 into 1 minus x raised to m we are considering as a t raised to minus 1 by 2 into dx. But what is dx? Dx is 1 upon m into 1 upon t raised to m minus 1 by m dt. Okay, so that implies I is equal to, now take constants outside, so 1 upon m we can take outside, so 1 upon m integration 0 to 1 into 1 minus t raised to minus 1 by 2, and this t raised to m minus 1 by m we can consider as t raised to power minus m minus 1 upon m is shifting this denominator term to the numerator, power becomes negative dt. Okay, so that implies I is equal to 1 upon m 0 to 1 1 minus t raised to minus 1 by 2. We have to consider, or we have to convert this power into minus 1 type, means minus 1 type, and this also minus 1 type. We use this basic definition of beta function. So don't mix the m and this mn. Okay, in the example the notation is m, and in this formula also we have the m, but both are the different things. Just keep it in mind that this power must be in the form of some number minus 1. This must be also some number minus 1. And what is that number? Minus 1 by 2. Surely I can write as minus 1 by 2. I can write as 1 by 2 minus 1. 1 by 2 minus 1. So this is for the minus 1 by 2. And this minus m minus 1 upon m, to write in the form of n minus 1, what must be n? N must be equal to 1 minus m minus 1 upon m, that is m minus m plus 1 upon m. So which is eventually what? This m cancels, so 1 upon m. It implies that this thing minus m minus 1 upon m, we can write as 1 by m minus 1. 1 by m minus 1. Okay, so using all these things, that integral I will now become, integral I will become, I is equal to what it is, I is equal to 1 upon m into integration 0 to 1 1 minus t raised to 1 minus t raised to minus 1 by 2, can write as 1 by 2 minus 1, this thing, and into t raised to this minus m minus 1 upon m, we can write as 1 upon m minus 1. So it is t raised to 1 upon m minus 1 dt. So that implies I is equal to, now by the formula of beta function, this integral I, it is beta of what? 1 upon m 1 upon 2. Beta of 1 upon m 1 upon 2. So that is I is equal to 1 upon m. We can use the formula or the relation between beta and gamma, as beta 1 by m 1 by 2 is gamma 1 by m gamma 1 by 2 divided by gamma of 1 upon m plus 1 upon 2. So the reason is, using this, beta p q is equal to gamma p into gamma q divided by gamma of p plus q. Therefore finally we have I is equal to 1 upon m into gamma 1 by m, it is as it is, and gamma 1 by 2, we know it is, gamma 1 by 2 is root pi. So it is root pi by m into gamma 1 upon m divided by gamma of 1 upon m plus 1 upon 2. This is the final answer. And here what we have used? We have used gamma 1 by 2 is equal to root pi. Just take care of this step. Always to express that power in the form of minus 1. So that you have to consider as n minus 1. Find that n by using this logic, so that there will be no mistake. So this is the final answer. Okay. Let us consider one more example. Example number 4. Evaluate fourth example we are considering. Evaluate integration 0 to 2 integration 0 to 2 x into 8 minus x cube bracket raised to 1 upon 3 dx. Okay, I think this is similar to the first example. In the first example, I think there was a term n minus x, and here we have the term 8 minus x cube. It is a similar structure, only what our requirement is what 1 minus t, and to get 1 minus t, what we must put. So we have to put here in the example x cube equal to, x cube is equal to obviously 8t. If I put x cube is equal to 8t, it will be 8 minus 8t, so that I can take 8 common. So 8 in the bracket, it will be 1 minus t, which is the required. So putting x cube is equal to 8 into t. So differentiating this, so that will give you 3x square dx is equal to 8 dt. That implies dx is equal to 8 upon 3 into 1 upon, here it is x square, here it is x square. So it is 8 upon 3 into 1 upon x square and dt. That implies dx is equal to 8 upon 3. What about x square? If x cube is equal to 8t, what you can say about x taking third root on both sides, cube root on both sides, x will be equal to 2 into t raised to 1 upon 3. This is the basic x. If you are considering x cube equal to 8t, it means x is equal to 2 t raised to 1 upon 3. This thing also you can use for dx. I will show that also. So first of all, let us consider this as x here. It is 1 upon x square, that is 2 t raised to 1 upon 3 square dt. That implies dx is equal to 8 upon 3. This 2 square is 4, means 8 upon 3 into 4, that is 8 upon 12 into 1 upon t raised to 1 by 3 square, that is t raised to 2 by 3 dt. That is eventually dx is equal to 8 upon 12. What is 8 upon 12? It is 2 by 3, and this t raised to 2 by 3 shifting to numerator, it will become t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt. So this is the substitution for dx. This also we can do by using this. I will show the alternate here. From this step itself, x cube is equal to 8t, that will give you x is equal to 2 t raised to 1 by 3 by taking cube root on both sides. Now if I differentiate this, x is equal to 2 t raised to 1 upon 3, I will get dx is equal to 2 into derivative of t raised to 1 by 3 is 1 upon 3 into t raised to 1 upon 3 minus 1 dt. So that will give you dx is equal to 2 upon 3 into t raised to 1 by 3 minus 1 is what? 1 by 3 minus 1 is t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt. And you can check this. This is same. So it depends on you what method you are using, but by both you will get the same thing. Is it clear? So what substitution we are doing? X cube equal to 8t, x equal to 2t raised to 1 upon 3, and dx is equal to 2 by 3 t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt. Also, we have to check the limits, whether the limits are changing or not changing. So let us consider that for x is equal to 0, what you can say about t when x is 0? So this will become 0 is equal to 8t. So that will give you 0 is equal to t. So t remains same, 0. For x is equal to 2, upper limit, what happens to t? If I take x is equal to 2, it will be 2 cube equal to 8t. That is 8 equal to 8t. That means that will give you t equal to 1. So limit changes. Limit changes to 0 to 1. Okay. So we have that with this substitution, that integral I will become right here. Therefore, with all these substitutions, that integral I will become, so what do you have? I will be equal to integration, limits are changing, 0 to 1. X is what? 2t raised to 1 upon 3. into 8 minus x cube we are considering as 8t bracket raised to 1 upon 3. And what is dx? Dx is 2 by 3 t raised to 2 by 3 t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt. Okay, so this will be the I after the substitution. Let us erase this to simplify further, so that I will become I is equal to, that implies I is equal to, take constants outside, so this 2 into 2 by 3 means 4 by 3 I can take outside, integration 0 to 1, t raised to 1 by 3 and this t raised to minus 2 by 3, so by law of indices it is 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3. Here I can have 8 common, but I have to consider this power also, so when I take 8 outside it will come with the power 1 upon 3, means it 8 raised to 1 upon 3 into bracket, what will remain, 1 minus t raised to 1 upon 3 dt. Okay, so that implies I is equal to this 8 also you can take outside, so 4 into 8 raised to 1 upon 3 divided by 3, integration 0 to 1, this will be 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3, so what it is, 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3 is 1 minus 2 means minus 1 upon 3 into 1 minus t raised to 1 by 3 dt. That implies, before going to this, let me simplify this, so it is I is equal to 8 raised to 1 by 3, that is cube root of 1 by 3, and what is cube root of 1 by 3, cube root of 1 by 3 is 2, so it is 4 into 2 means 8 upon 3, 8 upon 3, integration 0 to 1, t raised to minus 1 by 3, into 1 minus t raised to plus 1 by 3 dt. Okay, now construct here, t raised to 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, and 1 minus t raised to 1 by 3. So that minus 1 by 3, I want in the form of m minus 1. So that will give you m is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3, that is what? 1 minus 1 by 3, that is 2 by 3. And that 1 by 3, I want in the form of n minus 1. So that will give you n is equal to 1 plus 1 by 3, so that is 4 by 3. So with this m and n, this integral I we can write as, therefore that implies I is equal to 8 upon 3 integration 0 to 1 t raised to minus 1 by 3, I can write as m minus 1 with m as a 2 by 3, so t raised to 2 by 3 minus 1 into 1 minus t raised to 1 by 3, so that 1 by 3 we can write as n minus 1, which is 4 by 3 minus 1, so it is 1 minus t raised to 4 by 3 minus 1 dt. Simplify it further, so that implies I is equal to 8 upon 3, now this is by the definition of beta function, this integral I is beta of 2 by 3 comma 4 by 3. 2 by 3 comma 4 by 3. So further we can simplify it as I is equal to 8 upon 3. By relation between beta and gamma, this beta 2 by 3, 4 by 3 we can write as gamma 2 by 3 into gamma 4 by 3 divided by gamma 2 by 3 plus 4 by 3. So reason using this, beta pq is equal to gamma p into gamma q divided by gamma of p plus q. So that implies I is equal to 8 upon 3 gamma 2 by 3, let it be as it is. Now that gamma 4 by 3 I can write as 1 by 3 plus 1, because 4 by 3 is 1 by 3 plus 1, divided by gamma of, what about this, 2 plus 4 means 6, 6 by 3, that is 2, means it is gamma 2 just. So that is, now we have to use the properties of gamma function. What is gamma n plus 1? Gamma n plus 1 is n gamma n, gamma n plus 1 is n gamma n, so that I will be equal to 8 upon 3 gamma 2 by 3 as it is, and gamma 1 by 3 plus 1 we can consider as 1 by 3 gamma 1 by 3 using the formula or property gamma n plus 1 equal to n gamma n, and gamma 2 is 1 factorial. So I will mention here for this 1 by 3 gamma 1 by 3 I have written from this gamma n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n, and for this 1 factorial also same thing is gamma n plus 1 is equal to n factorial if n is integer, otherwise we have gamma n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n. So that will simplify I as I is equal to 8 upon 3 this 1 by 3 8 upon 3 into 1 upon 3 into 1 factorial is 1, so what remains only gamma 2 by 3 into gamma 1 by 3, so that is I is equal to 8 upon 3 this 3 into 3 it will be 8 upon 9. Now this gamma 2 by 3 and 1 by 3 2 by 3 we can consider as 1 minus 1 by 3, 2 by 3 is 1 minus 1 by 3, and this gamma 1 by 3 will remain as it is. Now you can use this property of gamma function, gamma p into gamma 1 minus p is equal to pi upon sine of p pi, pi upon sine of p pi, where that p lies between 0 and 1. So using this, that I will become I is equal to 8 upon 9, here p is 1 upon 3, so it is pi upon sine p pi, that is sine pi by 3. So that implies I is equal to 8 upon 9 into pi divided by, what is sine pi by 3? Sine 60. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. So simplify it further. So it is 8 upon 9 into 2 upon root 3 into pi. So that implies I is equal to, this will be 16, 8 into 2, 16 upon 9 root 3 into pi, or you may say 16 pi upon 9 root 3. This is the final answer. Okay, so this is how we have done the examples by using the basic formula, by keeping in mind that in every example our aim was to get the term of 1 minus p type, and accordingly we have done the substitutions. Now for practice, take some examples for practice. So you solve these examples, practice examples, to get command over this type. First example is evaluate integration 0 to 1 dx divided by cube root of 1 minus x cube. This is first example. And second example, evaluate integration 0 to 1 integration 0 to 1 1 minus x raised to 1 upon n bracket raised to m dx. Just give hint, for first example you have to put x cube as a t, and for second example what, put x raised to 1 upon n as a t. So solve this.